Hello, I welcome you all to this channel. Hope you all are doing well at your home. Today we are going to learn how to draw piston on SolidWorks. So for let us start. Click on File, select New and click Parts and OK. Here I am going to change my background. I generally prefer plain white background. Go to any point of the plane. Select. I am selecting front plane right now and select center line from here and click and give a center line with a roughly any magnitude in a vertical direction. Okay, now let us go to the line, but this time I'm not selecting line, I will select a spin line and give a certain magnitude in a horizontal in a x direction. Okay, and click right click and select OK. All right, and this time we are going to select line. And generally, if you have noticed a piston closely, then you have seen that there is a number of groups surrounding in a circular form surrounding the piston. Okay, now here. Now let us give a dimension to this all. I am giving 25 mm. Roughly all the dimensions are roughly selected. Just to teach you the trick how to draw and use which one of the features we have to use while drawing piston. You know, if you have learned once, you can draw any kind of a piston. Here we have seen that we have given 25 and now we are giving the how deep will be the groups. I'm giving it 1.5. Okay, and I am giving the what will be the total height of the that groove, that will be 2 mm. You have to notice that you don't have to select that middle point, you have to select that line and right click, and there will be an option display and you can select equal to those. Now go to the linear pattern. Here in x-axis you have to select only one, then it will be dissolved. And here we need three groups. We are drawing three groups for that. Now here you have to give from the first line to the, that's why we are giving 4 mm, because initially we are selecting this line and then this and then this. That's why from this line to the next same line we have to maintain this 2 mm, and the gap between these two groups will be 2 mm. Now you can see we here it is drawn on the circle. Now we have to give dimension to the these height will roughly take 30 mm. Okay, now we have to give a dimension to this, how thick will be the sidewall will be the thickness of 7 mm. Now we will give a dimension, I think let us give it to 15 mm. Okay, now you can see now if you have seen that piston closely, we have seen that there is a certain dome, the certain curve in their top head, you know, the head of the piston little bit curved. So just to make that, we have initially selected a spin line and drawn, and now we are stretched somehow to make it little, you know, bring a curvedness in that top surface. 25 mm we have also mentioned, but it is not necessary, but we have to give the okay. Now exit and go to feature and select revolve boss slash base. This is one of the important feature that every time you use while drawing, you know, a lot of thing. Now we have to select the here and click OK. Now you have already able to see that there is a instance already has been generated. Now we'll select the front plane and go to the sketch and select line, and here we'll draw a certain rectangular shape just to cut there. Okay, now we'll give a dimension to this. Here we'll give a dimension to, you know, this will give a 10 mm of dimension. 10 mm. Now we'll here we'll give to 3.5 mm. Now the depth will be 3 mm. Okay, and exit, go to feature, go to excluded cut, select sketch number 2 because the sketch we have drawn is second number. Select this and select not blind but through all. Okay, select OK. Here you can see there is a cut on the plenty of time you have noticed that there is a such cut we have on piston surface. Okay, now we have to go for the mirror. It is so easy, you can see that even after stopping or pausing it. Select this plane, go to this and bring to perpendicular. Okay, all right, now you have to draw a circle just where we fit our gudgeon pin. Okay, for this we'll go and touch that center lines, both the center line, and click there and bring it and draw it. Now let us give a dimension. We'll give a dimension of 8 mm. Here is two things, you can go for the offset or you can go to the circle also. I'm initially going to draw circle, and here we'll give a diameter of 5 mm. Now I need to give offset that so that it is, you know, that it have a same center. Select both the line with help of shift and click right, and here we'll make it concentric. Now go to feature, click excluded boss, and you need to select, I'm selecting 10 mm but in a reverse direction. Okay, and click OK. Now you can see that we have generated that profile of tube like profile where gudgeon pin will be fitted. Now we'll exclude it. This sketch, same sketch we have to select, exclude cut, go to exclude cut, select, this time we are selecting the sketch. Okay, now here we'll select up to next vertex and click OK. Here you can see that it is so simple to draw. Same thing, we are going to mirror it. For mirror, we'll again go to the select right plane, go to mirror, again select to the which you want to copy. We need to copy both excluded one and cut excluded both, because once you are excluding it, once you are cutting it for this, then you can see that you have already generated both the profile. Now once one of the if you have noticed that there is a certain cut in the cylinder like this. For this you have to draw a rectangle shape touching the baseline, as you've seen on the screen. Okay, let us give a dimension. Here we'll give a 10 mm. Here we'll give a 10 mm and now we'll give a dimension to this is also 10 mm, but SolidWorks already generated and it will display a alert message. Now we'll have to give this dimension, we'll give it to 13 mm. Okay, now we'll go for the fillet. You can see the fillet. You just have to go to this line and we'll click OK and select. We'll change it to 13. Alright, and click excluded. Select through all both, and you can see you have generated this profile. This is the piston we have drawn today. For again, go to select, you know, all body, and then go to change the appearance. Here I am selecting metal, okay, not metal, aluminium. I will go for aluminium and select and drag it to make it and click OK. Here you can see the this is our aluminium piston. It is all the dimensions are roughly selected. Thank you so much for watching.